Today, I'm going to show you one of my favorite practice projects for learning HTML and CSS. Really what it is it comes down to playing. I think that if you play and you're having fun, you're going to learn so much more than just doing the same simple, boring project over and over again. In this project, what you do is you play with HTML and CSS and you try to create images and pictures that you might not normally create when you're doing a web development project. So on the screen, you'll see that I have this spider. This is an example of playing. And what you can do is you can think about holidays that are coming up and try to create images that represent that holiday. So for here, I created an image for Halloween and I call it Halloween Family Fun. And it's using only HTML and CSS to create all of this animation. You can also do things based upon your favorite character, maybe like Batman, or just thinking about sort of different seasons, or maybe like outer space and you want to create a moon. And you'll notice that this is simple. Like, this is something that you can start with and then you just build upon it. So we start with a moon and the sky, the night sky, and then we move into maybe creating a rocket ship. Or we can even create some flat imagery, pixelated imagery, 32-bit imagery, and graduate and make it even more complicated. Now, I personally, I'm actually not really an artist. Majority of these images here, I've taken inspiration from other people and just recreated what they've created. And so I'm going to show you how to find an image to recreate. Now, what I like to do is I like to go into Google and I'll type in the word flat artwork, and you can type in flat artwork and then like the name of your favorite movie. And I guarantee you will probably find something that an artist has created. Now, when you're doing this, though, you want to make sure that you have the right Creative Commons or you give them reference to it as well. Tweak it so that way you're not blatantly ripping off an artist, right? Because someone did put their time into this. So I put in the word flat artwork into my Google search to find an image that I'm going to create into HTML and CSS. And what I do is I scroll down and I look basically at the complexity of this. Like, is this something that realistically at my skill set I can create? So maybe if I look at this and I want to maybe recreate one of these images in this six box. But then as I scroll down, I mean, this one would be a really good candidate to create. Look at all of these interesting angles and lines that we would have to create using HTML and CSS. Normally when we use HTML and CSS, it's just everything is either horizontal or vertical. We don't really have to create these organic shapes very often. But if you try this, you're gonna learn so much about what CSS and HTML can do. Scroll down the pages further. And I actually had it up here earlier. Like, for me, this is a great image for a beginner to learn how to do. I mean, you have a circle, you have some rectangles, maybe you overlap the rectangles, you put a border around it. Like, this is a very doable image. So then what you do is you download the image that you want to do. So I'm going to go over here, and for me, I have this image because I want to make sure that I'm using a royalty-free image, or one that I have license for. So I have an account for Stock Unlimited, and I see this image right here, and I feel like this is a doable image. I can definitely create this one. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm actually going to download this image. So I'm going to download this just as a JPEG right now. It doesn't really matter what file type you're using. Okay, so now I have my image and I have something I can start using for my HTML and CSS practice. Now, if you have Photoshop, let's say you want to get all these colors and have the colors be exactly the same. If you have Photoshop, you can use Photoshop to select these colors. But if you don't have Photoshop, that's completely okay. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to Pixlr.com. So that's Pixlr.com. And if you go there, you'll see that's Advanced Pixlr. So if I click on that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to upload an image. And I'm going to upload the image that I just downloaded, which I believe is this image right here. I'm going to select it, and there you go. So now I have my image in Pixlr. And what Pixlr allows me to do is it allows me to use this eyedrop tool and click on different sections of the page, and that will pull up my color. So you'll see, notice over here on this left-hand side that this color is being updated. So if I click here, that color is there. I get that shade of green or aqua. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this deeper shade of green and select it. And now I have my hex value that I'm going to want to use for my backgrounds, right? So I'm going to go ahead and copy that. All right. So the next step is where do I want to go ahead and put all of this stuff? Now, I showed you my examples here, and I use and I love, and a lot of people love, Codepen.io. So what you want to do is you want to go to codepen.io.com and sign up for an account. And then when you're in your account, you're going to click on this pin button over here. So in the pin, you can name your Codepen up on the top left. You have this HTML section, you have a CSS section, and you have a JavaScript section. And from here, again, the idea is to recreate that image that you have over in Pixlr. So I'm going to go ahead and I'll close some of these tabs out. Oh, not this tab. That's the tab I want. And you just start. So for me, I know that I want to have the background be that color. All right, look at that. I'm already pretty far, right? So then I go ahead and I can grab this color for the sun, and I'm going to say sun, and then I go to sun and I say background, and I'm just starting to create these shapes. I know that I need to create a circle, so I'm going to say, all right, display block. I'm gonna have a width of 100 pixels and a height of 100 pixels. And I'm gonna say border radius, and that's gonna be 50 pixels to make that a circle. So let's see. And why is it not updating with my, where is my error? I have sun. Background color. Did I use the same background color? I think I did. So let's go ahead and select that. Yep, that's my problem. Silly Miles. And so I click on that, change that over. All right, there's my sun. And then now you get to play around with the positioning of the page, right? So I might want to put this sun, and I'm going to move it like this into a wrapper. Maybe I want to kind of have a container. You can call it a wrapper or a container. Let's say display flex with, let's say 600 pixels. And right now I'm not really focused too much on mobile responsiveness. I'm just trying to create this image and make it look what I have here, right? So I'm trying to make it look similar. So then let's say margin 0 auto. There you go. And then I can move this. And you want to play with, let's say, padding on this guy, this wrapper. So you're starting to play around with positioning. Maybe I need to use an absolute positioning. Maybe I need to, use CSS grid. I don't know. There's so many different ways, but you're really just trying to use whatever information you know about HTML and CSS to be able to get this image looking exactly the same. If you want to get next level and you want to make sure that it is pixel perfect, you can even use this Marquee tool. And you can kind of select over here and highlight. And so now you know, okay, let me grab this box. Let me do this again. I'm trying to select as close, as tight into this as possible. Okay, so now I know that this sun is 211 pixels by 211 pixels. I saw that pop up on that screen. So I'm going to go ahead and go back here. And I want to make sure that's 211 and 200. 7. So that means I need to change this. So I can say 100% actually. There you go. So that's the actual size of that circle if I was to zoom in to the correct proportion. So probably something like that, right? That's what it's going to look like on my screen eventually. But yes, that's it. And then what you do is you continue to add more complexity to this. So as you get better and better at creating these flat images and figuring out all these angles, you start to pick harder images, or maybe you change the way that you do things. So right now I'm using HTML and CSS plain. Maybe I change this to SCSS so I can go ahead and I can nest things. So I can put in, rather than having it be like that, I can actually put this in here, and you'll notice that it's going to work. It's, which doesn't normally work with CSS because now I'm using SCSS. And maybe eventually what I want to do is I want to try using a different HTML preprocessor. Like, I personally love using HAML for code pens. I don't think that you're ever going to really use HAML in production unless you're using .NET. So most of us aren't going to, but you can use HAML like something like that, and look at how much cleaner that is. Or you can practice even using Markdown. The sky's the limit. Codepen is such a great resource to just push yourself and recreate images. And again, you don't need to have an artistic mindset when it comes to creating an image from scratch or creating an idea and drawing it out. Use other people's artwork as inspiration. Don't blatantly rip them off, obviously, or give them credit, but don't be afraid to see what's out there. And CodePen is just an amazing resource. You can look at codepen.io challenges. They have challenges of different design and design principles. You can also look at other people's code. So if I click on there and then I go to trending, you'll see that there's all sorts of wonderful designs and just amazing artwork that people are doing with HTML and CSS. If you want to find pure HTML and CSS, you can type in CSS pure CSS up here in the search bar, and you're going to get all sorts of examples that of ideas of what you can make with just pure HTML and CSS. And then if you want to look at their code, you just go ahead and click on it. Let's click view and editor. And now you can see the code that they used. So this is using SCSS, which is allowing them to make more complicated animation a lot easier. And you can see how they actually do this. So again, this is my favorite exercise for HTML and CSS, and it's just playing. It's recreating a flat image and kind of getting out of your mind about having to do the same design over and over again, a header, a navigation, and really just figuring out what you can do organically with CSS and HTML.